everybody to another Endless Theory event.
Feel the intensity in the crowd and on the racetrack.
They're saying he's going to be the one to watch today.
All these drivers all with one goal, become the champion.
Buckle up tight, folks. Here we go. Green flag is out.
Welcome back. We are here at Atlanta Motor Speedway continuing on what's been an exciting race weekend so far, the kind of Christmas edition race weekend, as we get ready for the running of the Vixen 300 here today in Division 2 of the Mobile One Cup Series of Season 4. On the pole for this race is going to be Bob Burgess. Ian O'Brien will line up alongside of him in second. Then you got Richard Johnson third. Fourth will be Keenan Bush. Pichu London, who comes in second in the standings, 16 points behind points leader Arnold Columbia. He'll line up in the fifth position. And in sixth place is going to be Matthew McMurray. There's quite a few drivers in this field who, due to the hard luck of certain drivers in Division 1, could capitalize and put themselves in a nice position heading into the second half of the season in points. Namely, Bob Carr is one of them. Another one would be... I believe Eric Matthews is in this field. I'll look through them and see if I can find the different drivers that we'll keep an eye on during the course of the day. But let's see these cars rolling off. Also, the question remains of who's going to join Diego Ospina as an official driver in the Mobile One Cup Series chase for the championship. There's going to be a lot of questions we'll answer in this race, but here's your starting grid. Here's a few drivers we'll keep an eye on during the course of the day. Actually, quite a few of them. Pichu London right there. He comes in second in the standings. A former winner a few weeks ago at Talladega. Mark Gillette, he's going to line up way here at the back of the pack. We'll keep an eye on him. Also, the car of Eric Matthews. Where is he? Whoops, I missed him. Going the wrong way. There he is, rookie Eric Matthews, who actually comes in fourth in rookie points as well. He is 7th in the standings, and another driver comes in the top 10 points. We'll actually just move up to him there, Wido Savotas. He is currently 9th in the points. I also believe Adam Chambers is in this field. Yes, he is. Adam Chambers right there in the 48. He comes in 10th in points, and just up ahead of him, James Qualls comes in 11th in points. So there's a lot of front runners in the point standings that are up here in this field. Green flag comes out, 33 laps of racing. Who's going to win this thing? Bob Fergus is going to lead them into turn number one. He's actually going to dominate them into turn number one. Now opens up about a car length lead over the rest of the field. Usually that's a good thing here at Atlanta. Unlike Talladega and Daytona, where you're a sitting duck, you want to pull away. You want to drive away from the rest of the field here at these intermediate tracks. And that's what Bob Fergus is trying to do, attempting to do, but I don't think it's working. I think Ian O'Brien is reeling him in for the lead. And there's a wreck as soon as we get under the green. There's a wreck here on the very first lap of this event. Fergus will lead us under the caution. It's Matthew Rodriguez, teammate Savannah Turner. Jordan Hester's involved. Haley Hamilton's involved. And possibly Wido Savotas, who came in 9th in points. Dylan Poteet's involved. Ryan Juke is in it. And the caution flies one more time. Well, actually, for the first time today, Ben Ward may have gotten a piece of it as well. I don't know how Dylan Poteet can see out of the front of that car. Well, he really can't. He's trying to, but I don't know if he can. That's where your spotter comes into play. Caution's out. Oh, man, that car is badly damaged, too, of Hester. Matt Rod's on pit road, and the caution's out. Pit stops being made. Eric Matthews deciding to stay out. As everybody else pits, let's look back at a replay. Now, quite a few of these drivers are going to be in the All-Star race anyway due to other wins and championships that were won, but there's the contact. It was Emilio Navarrete turning Matthew Rodriguez down into his own teammate, and Jordan Hester gets a big chunk of it right there. Watch Wido Savotas. Does he get involved here? Trying to slow up. I think he got a little piece of it. And, oh, Dylan Pote just kind of went into that with his eyes closed, ran right into the back of Ryan Juke. Two of those drivers, or three of those drivers involved, I do know are going to be in the All-Star race, Pote and Wido Savotas, due to wins both last season and this season. Matthew Rodriguez being a former Mobile and Cup Series champ, but Savannah Turner, she was trying to get into the All-Star race with a win today, and it's not going to happen. And same deal for Jordan Hester. Badly damaged race cars right there. Oh, and Haley Hamilton got into something afterwards. Let's see what happened to the 56. Oh, there it is right there. Last week's winner, Cody Lamas, is going to... Oh, no, it was Matthew McMurray and Keenan Bush getting together. Down into Haley Hamilton and Cody Lamas. Both those drivers, former winners. Cody Lamas winning last week at Arizona, and Haley Hamilton winning earlier on this season at Kentucky. And Haley just backed it into the outside retaining wall. Pretty bad damage by the 5-Hour Energy Toyota Camry as well. So we had about 6 or 7 cars involved here in the first lap of this event as the caution flew. They were actually coming down to receive lap number 2. Caution flies. Let's go back to green. Eric Matthews stayed out. Let's see how that pit strategy is going to work for that rookie. So we'll get ready to go green flag racing for our first restart of the day. Eric Matthews, as we mentioned, he stayed out. He was the only driver who did not come down pit road back on lap number 3. It's going to be interesting to see what kind of strategy is being played out there and if it'll work out into the favor of Eric Matthews. Maybe this is to keep him up front for when lap number 25 comes around. You never know. He's going to be the leader. Richard Johnson, who I believe worked a 2-tire pit stop, he's going to be second. There's also 2 tires for Tim Walsh. He's third. Same deal for Ian O'Broin in fourth. Alan Tanker in fifth. Ashley LaPlante in sixth. And Jacob Cook in seventh. First car to take on 4 tires was Bob Fergus. He'll restart eighth. Ninth, Anthony McCurry. Tenth, Emilio Navarrete. Then it's Alyssa Anderson, Devin Johnson, Adam Chambers, Pichu London, and James Qualls. That's the top 15. They get ready to go back to green. We have 4 drivers out of the race. They are the cars of Savannah Turner, Dylan Pote, Jordan Hester, and Matthew Rodriguez. So a tough break for those 4. They will not make the chase for the championship for the Mobile and Cup Series here in Season 4 due to the DNF here today at Atlanta. Question is, who is going to be joining Diego Ospina as the second driver to make the chase for the championship? We're going to find out very soon as Tim Walsh now goes to the inside. That's for the lead. Now, Tim Walsh, if he can end up leading lap number 25 today, that would make his choice a little bit easier. Don't forget, he ended up winning the Halloween trivia contest, and so he has a guaranteed spot in a chase of his choice. He only runs in Mobile and Snickers as he loses the lead now to Ian O'Broin, but if Tim Walsh can lead lap 25, get that Mobile and Cup Series chase spot, then he would be able to then use his trivia question opportunity to be able to go into the Snickers Cup Series chase for the championship and make the chase in both the series that he is in. As now the battle's on between Alan Tanker up high and Jacob Cook down low. Anthony McCurry right there as well. Looks like Jacob will take the lead off of turn number 2, but for how long? Here comes Anthony McCurry down to the inside. We've seen quite a bit here at Atlanta where a driver that's in the lead is able to pull away. Whoa, Ashley LaPlante nearly got turned by Bob Fergus. What a save by both those drivers. And Ashley will lead this lap. But we've seen where the leader gets out away from the rest of the field, and then they continue to battle for second, and it allows the leader to just kind of ride around out in front. We're not seeing that here today. They are battling for the lead just about every single corner into turn 2. Or rather, into turn 1, out of turn 2, into turn 3, out of turn 4, even in the middle of the front straightaway. And the pole sitter, Bob Fergus, the 4-tire strategy, going to put him back up at the front of the field. But here comes third in the standings, Pichu London, down to the inside. Let's not forget, Leah Walker won the Division 1 race. I'm sure she gave some advice to her TA2 Motorsports teammate, Pichu London, on how to get around this track at the right time. Be in the right place at the right time. But here comes Alyssa Anderson down to the inside. Oh, look out, look out, look out. Some contact between yourself and Eric Matthews. And oh, there goes Richard Johnson, Felix Graves, and Bob Ferguson to the fence there, as we've got a huge wreck on the front straightaway. The pole sitter is in it. Ian O'Brien's gotten a piece of it. Alan Tanker, Adam Chambers is in it. James Silverfox. Oh, Ben Ward just plastered somebody. Tim Walsh is in it. Emilio Navarrete is in it. Who did Ben Ward run into? That was full speed. I think he ran into Bob Fergus. James Qualls, he's involved. Anthony McCrory got a piece of it. There is Alan Tanker's machine. There's Ian O'Brien. They were involved. Ashley LaPlante looks like she got a piece of it. And I think Richard Johnson was involved as well. Leader under the caution this time is Alyssa Anderson over Eric Matthews. Let's look back at a replay of what just happened. That was quite a few front runners involved in this one. Well, amazingly enough, this thing started all the way back in turn number 3. Watch right here. Ashley LaPlante trying to see if she can go 4 wide underneath Fergus. And where's the contact going to start? Oh, and then Richard Johnson tries going 4 wide underneath of Felix Graves. So something at that point's gotta give. And the contact, yep, right there. Ashley LaPlante turns Bob Fergus down into Richard Johnson, comes up into Felix Graves. And then Ashley LaPlante went down into Adam Chambers. Oh, man. Anthony McCrory jacked up Chambers. Chambers went up and into the catch fence there. Went up on top of Tim Walsh's machine. Oh, Whito Savotas and Darren Quinn. Didn't see those two involved, but they got plastered. There's James Silver Fox, 2-time winner, right in the middle of that. Adam Chambers and James Qualls, who both come in top 15 in points. Both the Lilly Trucking cars involved. Good miss there by both last week's winner, Cody Lamas and Keenan Bush. And then watch here. I don't know which car it is that gets it. It may be Felix Graves. But watch coming in right side of your screen. You're going to see Ben Ward in the 51. He's going to come driving through this at full speed. No regard for the fact that these drivers are all slow. I think he's coming in right here. And I don't know if he hits Felix Graves or Bob Fergus right there. Yeah, he hits Fergus. Look at how that just shoots Fergus. My goodness. Oh, and Cody Lamas did get involved in something. Now, how did he get a piece of this? Did he get clipped by somebody? Last week's winner is involved. He's got some pretty bad damage. Let's see here. Oh, yeah. He was able to get down to the bottom of the racetrack to avoid this, but not to avoid Whito Savotas further up here. Right there. Oh, man. He nailed him pretty hard. Keenan Bush. Oh, wow. What a miss by Keenan. Wow. Oh, Darren Quinn's up there at the high side of the racetrack, too, after he got nailed by Whito Savotas. That just kind of backs everybody up here. Tim Walsh is slowed up. Can't go anywhere. James Qualls, same deal. I don't know who's going to be able to continue. Oh, there you see again. Man, Fergus just boing after he gets hit by Ben Ward. My goodness. Getting a little extra oomph. Well, this is a lot of drivers involved, and I don't know how many of them are going to be able to continue. A lot of hard licks taken on the front straightaway here on lap 11. I think we're going to be narrowing down the field once more as we go back to green flag racing. So, we're going to go back to green. Eric Matthews did not make a pit stop. I thought he might make the opportunity to come down pit road this time, since he was the only driver who stayed out when they made pit stops back on lap 3. But nope, he's still in second, right behind leader Alyssa Anderson. Lot more drivers back in the garage area now. Alan Tanker's back there. Anthony McCrory's back there. Same for pole sitter Bob Fergus. Darren Quinn. Last week's winner Cody Lamas. Whito Savotas. Adam Chambers. And Ben Ward. That leaves us only 20 cars on the racetrack and on the lead lap. Let's show them to you now. Alyssa Anderson's the leader. Eric Matthews second. Pichu London third. Fourth, Matthew McMurray. And Jacob Cook is fifth. Devin Johnson runs in 6th. 7th is DeVar O'Broin. Mark Gillette, who is up there 2nd in the points, he is 8th. 9th is Richard Johnson, and Ashley LaPlante runs in 10th. 11th is Eric Burton. 12th is Felix Graves. 13th is Ian O'Broin. 14th is James Silver Fox. 15th is James Qualls. Emilio Navarrete is 16th. 17th is Keenan Bush. Haley Hamilton is 18th. Ryan Juke 19th. And Tim Walsh completes the rest of the field in 20th place. Still a lot of front runners still in this thing. Eric Matthews, Pichu London, James Qualls, Mark Gillette. Here we go. Green flag comes back out. We got about 10 more laps before lap number 25 will go up on the board. And remember, it's not who leads the beginning of lap 25. It's who leads the lap, the end of lap 25. And we're going to find out very soon who's going to join Diego Ospina as a championship contender for the Mobile One Cup Series Championship after race weekend number 15 at Arizona. Right now, battle on for the leads between Alyssa Anderson and Pichu London, but Jacob Cook's getting a good run out of turn 4. Whoa, I think he wanted to put a move on Pichu London there for a second, but London put the block on him and also is going to go down to the inside of Alyssa Anderson. That's for the lead. A few other contenders here that may end up coming into play. How about Richard Johnson? He did quite a great save back there on that last caution. By all rights and means, he should have gone up and plastered the outside retaining wall with the right side of that snap-on Chevrolet, but he kept it together, almost kind of like Diego Ospina. The question is now, Diego Ospina was able to save his race car and get himself a spot into the chase for the championship. Can Richard Johnson do the same? Whoa, nearly didn't right there as he nearly turned DeVar O'Broin, and back there, Mark Gillette nearly turned Alyssa Anderson, but we're still green. Pretty impressed as well with the strategy of one Eric Matthews. He's been able to stay out, not have to come down pit road. Can he make it the rest of the way on fuel? I don't know. I highly doubt it, but we'll see. Maybe if Matthews can stay out, lead lap number 25, he then may not care where he ends up finishing this race. He may end up coming down, making a pit stop then. Maybe that's his strategy. Maybe going all out. And he's going to go to the front right here. Matthew McMurray right behind him. Mark Gillette trying to win his second race in 3 weeks. He won 2 weeks ago at Talladega. He also is trying to run down, whoa, four wide with Alyssa Anderson. Oh, they're making some contact here. But they're going to narrow it back to three wide perhaps. Oh, that was a good move right there. But Mark Gillette, as I was saying, he's trying not only to pick up his second win of the season, but he also, oh, wait a minute, Matthew McMurray, Eric Matthews. Boy, I'm not getting to say what I want to say. Mark Gillette's trying to run down Arnold Columbia for the points lead in the standings. Good finish today, and hard luck by Columbia Division 3 race could end up having that happen. Eric Burton out of the front. This has been a really good season so far for Eric Burton in the Mobile One Cup Series. He's running in the top 20 in points. I think he's actually running top 15, somewhere around 13th, 14th in points. And looking for his first Mobile Cup Series win of his career. He's already got a Truck Series win, which is his first and an SCRA victory, and that came back at Arizona last week. And oh, is the caution out? The caution is out. Caution is waving, and Eric Burton is the leader. Lap 21 went on the board. I don't know if we're going to get back to green flag racing before lap 25 or not. Caution this time came out for it. May have been Ryan Juke. No, it wasn't either. It was, oh, Matthew McMurray and Alyssa Anderson. Two drivers who were running up inside the top 10, getting together here on lap 21. We got to take a look at a replay. There's Anderson and there's Matt McMurray. This must have been something that took place, I believe, heading into turn number 1. No, it was another incident out of turn 4. Textbook thing of what we've seen all weekend long. Right there, Mark Gillette going to hook Alyssa Anderson down into Matthew McMurray. Nowhere for McMurray to go, and Alyssa Anderson basically just a passenger as well. Oh, pretty hard lick for Matt McMurray. Becomes a sandwich between the outside retaining wall and Alyssa Anderson. They're both going to slide across the stripe. I believe they crossed in 9th and 10th, or 10th and 11th. But obviously not the way they wanted to slide to go across the start-finish line. Be interesting to see if they can continue on. Matthew McMurray's car pretty badly damaged. Alyssa Anderson, not so much. She kind of caved in on the driver's side of her 73, but she can continue on. If we can go into a possible one-lap shootout on lap number 25, it's no saying Alyssa Anderson may not still get it. Let's now go back to the green flag and see if the caution will still remain out on lap 25, or will we race that lap under the green flag. Getting ready to go back to green flag racing on lap 25. You heard correct. Lap 25 is when we'll go back to green flag racing. They'll get the green flag the next time around. The driver who leads that lap will be in the chase for the Mobile Cup Series Championship. Will it be Eric Burton, the leader? Will it be Devin Johnson, who came into this season? His first race was at Hidden Valley. Could he end up making the chase? Eric Matthews starting third. How about him? Pete Jew London starting fourth. And Richard Johnson starting fifth. But don't count out the rest of these drivers. Jacob Cook in seventh. Mark Gillette eighth. Alyssa Anderson ninth. Tenth Ashley LaPlante. Or ninth Ashley LaPlante. My apologies. And tenth Felix Graves. 11th Keenan Bush. Two-time winner Silver Fox in 12th. Haley Hamilton 13th. 14th Ian O'Brien. James Qualls 15th. 16th Emilio Navarrete. 17th Tim Walsh. 18th, Ryan Juke. Anything can happen. We don't see Matthew McMurray. He has actually taken his car back to the garage area. It leaves us 19 cars on the lead lap, 19 cars on the racetrack. But we're going to find out here in one lap who is going to make the chase for the Mobile Cup Series Championship with Diego Ospina. Eric Burton in for the lap of his life. Here we go. Green flag is back out. He's got to make four more corners, 1.5 miles. To be able to clinch himself a spot in the Mobile One Cup Series chase for the championship. He got himself a nice restart there, about 2 car lengths advantage. You think we were talking about the last lap, but no. This is lap 25 of 33. We're still going to have 8-9 laps to go once they get back to the stripe. But Eric Burton, a commanding lead. He wanted it. He's going to get it. Out of turn 4, Eric Burton will join Diego Ospina. He has clinched himself a spot in the Mobile One Cup Series chase for the championship by leading lap 25. What a big day for that 2017. And now he wants to not only make the chase, but he wants to make the All-Star race with a victory here today. But now I think he's about to get some challenges in the forms of Pete Jew London, Mark Gillette, Jacob Cook, Richard Johnson, Eric Matthews, and Devin Johnson. Here they come out of turn 4. Pete Jew London gets a good run off turn 4. Will he try and make a move here at the stripe? Here he comes to the inside. Pichu down to the inside line. Total of 6 laps to go as here comes Pichu to the inside. He will take the lead off turn 2. Now side by side between 2 Mustangs. Jacob Cook down low and Eric Burton up high. But I don't think Eric Burton quite cares where he finishes in this race because he now has a guaranteed spot in the Mobile One Cup Series chase for the championship. Pete Jew London going to come down. He'll lead another lap there in the 50. How would it be for TA2 Motorsports to end up going 2-for-2 in Mobile One Cup Series starts here at Atlanta? Leah Walker won yesterday in the Division 1 race. Pete Jew London would love to win here in Division 2. Eric Matthews right here to the inside of Richard Johnson. That's for second. That's going to allow Pete Jew London to open up a little bit of daylight on the field. So he's going to come down. Oh, Eric Matthews got turned! Matthews got turned. Did he save it? Yes, he did. What a save by Matthews. Getting turned off the nose of Mark Gillette. But he kept it together, and he's still running inside the top 5. That was a great save right there. But Pete Jew London, he's driving away, almost using the same kind of a tactic we saw Leo Walker do at the closing stages of the Prancer 300. We're now in the Vixen 300, and what? Wait a minute. Maybe I spoke too soon. His lead suddenly dwindling, and now he's got no lead at all. Eric Burton down back to the inside. When they come around, there'll be 3 laps to go. Eric Burton would love to complete the sweep. The sweep meaning that he gets himself a spot in the chase by leading lap 25, and he gets himself a spot in the All-Star race by leading lap number 33, the last lap of this event. Burton trying to win his second NSRA victory. As now the battle's on between Pete Jew London and Jacob Cook. That's for second. Mark Gillette still very much in this in fourth place. And don't count out Eric Matthews either. Here it comes down to the inside. That's Mark Gillette looking for second on Pichu London. Eric Matthews almost looked like he wanted to go for third. And oh, look at that. Eric Matthews kind of returning the favor to Mark Gillette, turning him off turn number four. Whoa, whoa, slower car. Slower car of Ryan Juke. They're trying to miss him. Burton gets held up. Eric Burton gets held up behind the slower car as they're going to come around. They'll get the white flag next time by. Whoa, watch it. Almost some contact between Richard Johnson and Eric Matthews, and they're going to go three wide for the lead. Richard Johnson, way down low. Devin Johnson right behind him. No relation. White flag in the air. It's going to come down maybe between the Johnson, but what a run Pichu London got through that corner. Came right up against the back bumper of Devin Johnson. Don't count him out. Mark Gillette, does he have anything still left in the tank? Here we go. Richard Johnson through the back straightaway and into turn three. Will he receive any challenge? Devin Johnson trying to run him down for his first career win of his S-Series career, but it's not going to be enough. Out of turn four for the final time. Richard Johnson will pick up his second Mobile One Cup Series win of his career. He wins the Vixen 300 at Atlanta. He had a victory last season, which I'm almost wanting to say. Boy, I can't remember the name of the track. But that was his first win of his Mobile Cup Series career, and now he's got a second one here in Season 4. And what a win for that team. Right place, right time, and he didn't take any challenges there through turns 3 and 4. Now, the final chapter in this story, folks, is that Eric Burton, he's going to clinch himself a spot in the Mobile One Cup Series chase for the championship. Richard Johnson wins his second race of his career in the NSCRA. Second win of the Mobile One Cup Series career as well. Clinches himself a spot in the All-Star race, which I believe he already had, but he'll now come into the All-Star race as a two-time winner in the Mobile One Cup Series. And we may end up having a big point shakeup as well. Mark Gillette was able to finish with a top five spot. All eyes will be on Arnold Columbia in the Division 3 race. Thanks for watching, everybody. Here comes the official finishing results. The points names will be coming up at the end of the Division 3 race. Please like this video if you enjoyed the race. Please comment if you were in this division race in order to keep your ride. And subscribe to join the crew today. We continue on the Christmas race weekend here at Atlanta. You can watch a prediction of the NSCRA offline racing at its best.